Then, let's look at the test of control. After have an understanding of internal control, if the internal control is weak, the auditors do not need to perform test of control. If the internal control is good, the auditors will perform test of control to obtain evidence about the operating effectiveness of controls. The approach is to identify controls likely to prevent or detect material misstatements and perform test of controls to determine whether they are operating effectively. Tests of control address the following: how control were applied, the consistency with which controls were applied, and by who or by what means the control were applied. The audit procedures used to test the effectiveness of internal control include inquiry of appropriate client personnel, inspection of documents and reports, observation of the obligation of controls, re-performance of the controls. As we mentioned before, the results of the test of control are used to determine the nature, timing, and the extent of substantive procedures. So you can see the table in here. So now, let's go to the summary of this chapter. In this chapter, we mentioned three items. First, we talk about the definition and five elements of internal control. Second, we introduce the method to document internal control. And last, we explain the nature of test of control. Okay, you can see the chart here. Now let's look at the professional terms. Internal control, 内部控制, control environment, 控制环境, risk assessment, 风险评估, control activities, 控制活动, information and communication, 信息与沟通, monitoring, 监督监控, questionnaire, 问卷, written narratives,书面叙述 flowcharts 流程图 So, we finish chapter 7 here. Thank you for your listening.